Well, today I want to encourage you out of a story that keeps coming to mind. It's 2 Chronicles 20, and it's the story of Jehoshaphat, how he was surrounded by the armies of kings. There were 3 kings, I think, who came against him. They wanted to take him out. They wanted to take the people out. And then it tells me in 2 Chronicles 20, verse 3, that Jehoshaphat feared. And I love the way it starts out with Jehoshaphat feared, because in this day and age, there are a lot of us are surrounded by opportunities to fear. It's a tangible presence of fear in the world. And I don't think there's anybody who's immune to fear, but it's what we do with the fear that determines the outcome of our battle. And so the very next thing that it tells me in the scripture in 2 Chronicles 20, Jehoshaphat feared and set himself to seek the Lord. I'm telling you, that is the answer to anything in this life that presents us with an opportunity to fear. When we can turn aside and we set ourselves, we make a quality decision to seek the Lord. Because if we just give in to the fear and we're overwhelmed by the fear, what happens is we're paralyzed. We can't make decisions. There's confusion that sets in. There's hopelessness and discouragement and all these terrible things that are attached to fear. If we just let fear in and we give in to it, fear, worry, anxiety, stress, there's scriptures right through the Bible that say, do not worry, do not fear, don't be discouraged, you know, be courageous, all of these things. But fear is a very real enemy, and the purpose is to paralyze us. But if we're going to recognize the fear and we're going to turn aside as Jehoshaphat did and set ourselves to seek the Lord, the answer is going to come, the faith is going to come, the solution is going to come, the strategy from heaven is going to come, so that we can overcome that overwhelming fear. So when Jehoshaphat set himself to seek the Lord, he called a fast, everybody prayed, fasted, and then what Jehoshaphat did was he began to tell God how great he was. He began to say to God, are you not our God who drove out the inhabitants of this land before your people? He was saying, God, is there not power in your hands? He was telling God who he knew God to be. And this is what praise is all about. This is why praise is so important when we fear. We turn aside to seek God, and we might not have the answers right there, but if we begin to tell God who he is, because that's what praise is, we begin to tell him who he is, we say, God, you are great, you delivered me before, you provided for me before, you healed for me before, and so this is who I know you to be. Praise is not making God feel good about himself. He doesn't need to feel good about himself. He knows who he is. But when we praise God, we're stepping out of the natural reaction, which is fear, and we're stepping into the supernatural ways of the kingdom, and we're inviting God into the battle. That's what praise does. We tell him who he is. We say, God, you healed me before. You are my healer. And he steps into the battle as your healer. If you need provision, you say, God, you did it before. You remind the devil and you remind God of the testimonies. You did it before. This is what Jehoshaphat was doing. And so Jehoshaphat, when he didn't know what to do, he turned aside in the midst of the fear and he said, God, this is who I know you to be. These are the stories I heard about you before. These are the things I've experienced before, and I'm inviting you into the battle. And God stepped in, and God's answer was, the Spirit of the Lord came upon Jahaziel in the assembly of people, and he brought the word, which was the strategy for warfare. And in that, in the whole answer that the Spirit of the Lord said through this person, it was, you're not going to need to fight this battle. You're going to stand still and see the salvation of God. Now, many people are needing this in this time. And they're striving and they're stressing and they're having sleepless nights and they're getting sick with worry. But your solution, your strategy now needs to be to stop giving in to the fear. You might have all the feelings of fear. You might not be able to sleep at night. It's a very real thing. But the only answer for you, the only strategy that you can do, is to set yourself to seek the Lord. And I'm telling you, as you begin to praise him, as you begin to remember the times he delivered you before, he's going to step right into the battle with you, and he's going to show you that the battle is his and it's not yours. And what fear does, more than just paralyzing you, fear makes you see things that are not really there. Fear makes you see the worst case scenario. Fear makes you lie awake at night in your bed and think, oh, I'm going to die of coronavirus, or this is going to happen and this is not going to happen. And all the time God is saying, begin to praise me, begin to worship me, begin to tell me who you know me to be. Remember my goodness to you in times gone by, and invite me into the battle, and the answers will come. So be encouraged with that today.